My father, Alex Mason, gave up everything he had. He abandoned me so he could defend his country from people like you. I hated him for that. But now, here I am. With you.
So we are the same, David. Shaped by those we have lost.
I throw this to the wind. Oh, what if I was right? Well, did you trust your noble dreams and gentle expectations to the mercy of the
And welcome to you guys. I am back. I'm back in the game. And it feels good to be back. This is Call of Duty Black Ops 2. Yes, it's another first-person shooter. But I like them. I know there's a lot of controversy about first-person shooters. There's a lot of people who hate them because they have not been very innovative in the last years, and that's true to some degree. They have been kind of doing the same thing over and over again. Especially the Call of Duty games have been guilty of this. But what you get is like a corridor shooter. It's fairly scripted. There's no real choice. You go through one part to the other. It's not open world. You're getting guided, you know, held by a leash. And you know what? I'm okay with that. I really am. Because that's what I expect in my modern first-person shooters. I expect big explosions, big production value, lots of orchestral music or high quality music, good voice acting, motion capture, cool guys with beards shooting people, and I get to be in the middle of it, in first person. Right there with them. It's like, I know what this game is. It's not fooling me. I'm actually allowing myself to be fooled. And that's totally okay with me. As I said, I'm here. I'm here for the experience of being in an action movie in first person. And I love that. I was one of the guys who actually loved the Battlefield 3 map, where you flew around as a co-pilot. And I had no trouble with that at all. Being on rails, you know, dumping flares on, from time to time, shooting people or airplanes. Cause I was just there for experience. The experience. It was great graphics, great sound, great music. And of course, I'm not naive enough to think that that's the real thing. It's like that to be a fighter pilot. But it's probably the closest thing I'm gonna get. So I like it. I like these games. And yeah, this is Black Ops 2. I have LP Black Ops 1, which is one of the more fun FPSs I played. I like the story. I like the characters. Don't expect me to know all the characters' names, because, well, the thing is, there's different characters for Call of Duty Modern Warfare and of Call of Duty Black Ops. Different main characters, and there's several of them, since sometimes you tend to jump between characters. But I believe Mason was the main character in number one, and I believe you play as his son in this game. There was Woods, who apparently died, and Reznov, of course, the cool Russian. I don't know if you know the story of Black Ops 1, but it was implied that Mason actually killed the president, Kennedy, because he was reprogrammed by the Russians. And yeah, I think that's it. And this game takes place 2025, I think, as you saw in the intro there. So it's nice to see a game in the future. Now we just need a Call of Duty game or Battlefield game set like 800 years in the future. Or in the Warhammer 40k universe. Oh man. Anyway, enough babbling. I'm going to check on some options, and I'll be right with you guys again. See you soon.